I can't just lump it because I'm working with an attorney on this, so I have to be very careful. So let's just do.
Morning.
How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good, thanks.
Any discounts today?
Yeah, we have discounts today.
Okay.
You find some good stuff?
Possibly, yeah. I'll keep looking around.
Do you want to put it in a little pile over here?
I think I'll do that. Thank you. Yeah.
Want me to grab it?
I think I'll...
Actually, let's just put it in the box.
Sure. Thank you so much.
And then we'll just put a fold on it for you.
I appreciate that.
Okay. Any of those things, or are you just still looking at it?
Still kind of looking.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
I'll put it right here, though.
So do you price me out, or
yeah.
do they
are you all done?
Sure.
Thank you.
built a barn?
Yeah, with two stories. He built a third story to it.
There's a little table there. I think
I think I'm done.
Okay.
The other lady said you guys could work with me on price a little bit.
Yeah.
See, I don't know how much the books were.
About $5.
Okay, that's fine.
Well, lost my page.
I got 4 and 3, 8, 25. I'm assuming this was probably 4. It was right next to that.
Mm-hmm.
4, 6, and 2.
Okay. So, what do you want to do?
Let's see. 8, 10, 18, 21, 46, 50, 56. 56 and 5 is 61. About $40.
Okay, I need to do this separate.
Sure.
I need to be, I can't just lump it because I'm working with an attorney on this, so I have to be very careful. So let's just do, so it's 61 and you want to do 40?
Uh-huh.
Can you do 45?
Sure.
All right. I'll tell you what, let me just write this down. I'm going to put this, I'll deal with this later.
All righty. Give it 5. Thank you so much.
Thank you. See you next time.
Yeah, absolutely.
Hey guys, it's now Monday morning. I went to an estate sale yesterday and got some pretty cool stuff. I'm going to show you. So everything here totaled up to $61 is what they were asking. And I offered 40, she counted with 45, and I said, yeah, that works for me. So I got a $16 discount on everything. I got this Night Before Christmas 8mm film. Pretty good time of year to get that too. I'm going to throw that on eBay right away. Got a couple of these pots. I guess these are, or maybe for either like creamer. I think they're too small for coffee and tea. They're not very big. The reason I got them is because both of them have hotel stamped on the bottom. Might be hard for you guys to see that, but this one's is stamped Hilton Hotel. It's International Silver Company. So these are probably both silver plated. This one needs some cleaning up, but it is also silver plated. And it says Sheraton Hotel. So these definitely have some age to them. They've got a cool look. I think they'll do well being specifically from hotels. Got this Philco speaker. I doubt that it works. Well, it might actually. It's pretty clean. The connector's good. It just has a really awesome vintage look to it. Got a little Garmin Nuvi GPS. These aren't super valuable. That might be like a $15 piece, but should be an easy seller. Got an old Shriners Club ashtray. They got a number of ashtrays, and I just decided on this one. Looks like the bottom's kind of peeling a little bit. That's too bad. Wish I would have caught that. This is probably my coolest find there. This is an old Florida orange coin bank. Couldn't find any kind of sold comps or anything, so I think it's a little bit rare and uncommon. Hoping to get somewhere between $50 and $100 for that. This was interesting. This is a tape player. See if I can wiggle it out of here and show it to you guys. This was made by Longines or Longines, L-O-N-G-I-N-E-S. I'm probably mispronouncing that, but it's a watch company, and they made this stereo, which I didn't know they made anything like that, and it's really clean. Those are going for about $25 on eBay. I got some books. I always love looking at books at garage and estate sales, and I feel like they're overlooked a lot. People just don't, you know, they see a bookshelf full of books, and they're like, eh, whatever. They walk right by them, but I love looking through the books because every once in a while I can find a pretty good one. Let's see, I got this old Junior Food and Clothing. Here's a Webster's Dictionary from the 40s. Here's an old quality control book. This one I just bought because I thought the cover looked cool. This is from the 70s. Looks like this one's gonna sell for about 10 to 15 bucks. And this was definitely the best find. It caught my eye because it said IBM, precision measurement in the metalworking industry. And I think it's from 50s. Yeah, 1952. So I'm excited to try to find comps on this one. I didn't see anything active or sold. So I think this might be a pretty uncommon book. got a lot of writing in it, which is a little unfortunate, but I still think there's going to be a market for this. Anytime I find IBM-related stuff that's vintage, I pick it up. But yeah, I paid $1 each for those. That's it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.